In Russia, a rap battle is brewing. In one corner, the president of Russia, Vladimir Putin, and in the other, the nation's hip-hop artists. Listen. The Russian president is weighing in on official efforts to crack down on rap music. He said Saturday it is an important part of pop culture, but he also said it needed to be guided by the state. The comments come after the detention of Husky, a popular Russian rapper who you see here. Let's go live to the Russian capital, CNN's Fred Pleitgen, following the story. And rap guided by the state, Fred? Huh?
Yeah, I mean, it seems like a bit of a contradiction, doesn't it? But it certainly has been a big problem here in Russia. I would say it's been sort of brewing over the past couple of months. And that rapper that we just saw there, Husky, he's sort of been at the center of the scandal that's been going on here in Russia. He had a couple of concerts that were canceled, a couple of concerts that were stopped because obviously some of the local officials didn't like some of the lyrics that he has in his songs. And the reason why he was arrested is, I think we're seeing it right now, is because after one of his concerts was canceled due to the fact that local officials didn't like what he was saying, he tried to put on a performance on the roof of a car, and then he was arrested and he was in jail for 12 days. And I think he is out by now. But of course, there is a lot of problem for him and for other rappers as well to actually be able to put on these shows. And it was interesting that Vladimir Putin is weighing in all this because he says that he spoke to a language expert about all this. And this language expert told him that rap is just simply right now for young people a part of popular culture. And that's where Vladimir Putin came up with the fact that he believes that it cannot be banned, but he does believe that the state needs to guide it. Of course, the state here in Russia guides a lot of things in multiple ways. And so now they're trying to come up with a strategy to do it now. And I want to just read to you one quote where he said, "One thing I agree with completely is if it's impossible to stop, then it is necessary to navigate and guide accordingly. But how to do so depends on us." So it looks like they're going to have to come up with some sort of strategy of how they want to do this. Meanwhile, all this keeps brewing. And one of the big issues that Vladimir Putin says that he has with the rap music is that he believes that three things are important in a lot of the lyrics. That is drugs, sex, and of course also protest. Now, of course, protest is a hot ticket issue here, but Vladimir Putin says to him the biggest problem is rapping about drugs and glorifying drugs, and that's the reason why he believes the state needs to find some sort of way to guide rap music and to guide young people, George.
Interesting, Fred. One other question to you. Is there a greater threat? So you bring up the issue of protest. As you laid out the other issues, protest certainly one that comes to the fore. Is that the bigger issue here?
Well, on the face of it, Vladimir Putin says no. He says, look, for him, drugs are the big issue. And he said he believes that people rap also, as far as the sex issue is concerned, about a lot of their body parts. It's not necessarily something that he wants to necessarily hear, but it's also not necessarily something that he says that he wants to restrict. But of course, here in Russia, there is a track record of trying to rein in protests and trying to stop at least public protests. So certainly there are a lot of people, Husky probably being one of them, this rapper, who believes that the protest part of it is the actual real problem. And if you look at some other popular culture acts, like for instance the band Pussy Riot, who have obviously very much been restricted, members have been in jail. They accused the Russian government of poisoning one of their band members, which of course the Russian government denies. And there have in the past been problems with bands that have lyrics that are contradictory to some of the things that the state wants to hear here. So it's a delicate issue. And you can tell that Vladimir Putin knows it's a delicate issue here, because trying to completely rein this in is something that could cause a lot of problems, especially with young people here in Russia. But at the same time, they do want to influence it somehow and make it, I think they would think, less dangerous for what they see as the stability of the government, the stability of the state. And they don't, on the face of it, say that protest is the bigger problem, but it certainly does also seem to be a problem, at least for a lot of these local officials who canceled some of the concerts here in Russia, George.
Well, maybe if he were to hear some old school Atlanta rap like Outkast, it could change his mind, but I don't know, Fred. I'm dating myself. Fred Pleitgen live for us in Moscow. Thanks
maybe we'll send him some.
Yeah, for sure. Thank you.